verses about divorce. Divorce has become common today, even among Christians. Divorce affects both spouses and kids that may be involved, and even both families that are involved. God created marriage and intended it to be good for us. When sin entered, so did the breaking of relationships. Divorce is mentioned several times in the Old and New Testament, as God hates divorce, and there are very few exceptions where divorce is allowed in Scripture. Here are 78 Bible verses about divorce from the Old and New Testaments of the Holy Bible. 1. Genesis 2:24 Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife. And they shall be one flesh. 2. Deuteronomy 22:29 Then the man that lay with her shall give unto the damsel's father 50 shekels of silver, and she shall be his wife, because he hath humbled her, he may not put her away all his days. 3. 1 Corinthians 7:10-11 And unto the married I command, yet not I, but the Lord, let not the wife depart from her husband, but and if she depart, let her remain unmarried, or be reconciled to her husband, and let not the husband put away his wife. 4. Mark 10:11 And he saith unto them, Whosoever shall put away his wife, and marry another, committeth adultery against her. 5. 1 Corinthians 7:15 But if the unbelieving depart, let him depart. A brother or a sister is not under bondage in such cases. But God hath called us to peace. 6. Matthew 1:19 Then Joseph her husband, being a just man, and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privily. 7. Mark 10:12 And if a woman shall put away her husband, and be married to another, she committeth adultery. 8. 1 Corinthians 7:39 The wife is bound by the law as long as her husband liveth, but if her husband be dead, she is at liberty to be married to whom she will, only in the Lord. 9. Ephesians 5:33 Nevertheless let every one of you in particular so love his wife even as himself, and the wife see, that she reverence her husband. 10. Romans 7:2 For the woman which hath an husband is bound by the law to her husband, so long as he liveth. But if the husband be dead, she is loosed from the law of her husband. 11. Matthew 19:6-7 Wherefore they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. They say unto him, Why did Moses then command to give a writing of divorcement, and to put her away? 12. Deuteronomy 24:1-3 When a man hath taken a wife, and married her, and it come to pass, that she find no favor in his eyes, because he hath found some uncleanness in her, then let him write her a bill of divorcement, and give it in her hand, and send her out of his house. And when she is departed out of his house, she may go, and be another man's wife. And if the latter husband hate her, and write her a bill of divorcement, and giveth it in her hand, and sendeth her out of his house, or if the latter husband die, which took her to be his wife. 13. Leviticus 21:7 They shall not take a wife that is a whore, or profane, neither shall they take a woman put away from her husband. For he is holy unto his God. 14. Romans 7:2-3 For the woman which hath an husband is bound by the law to her husband, so long as he liveth. But if the husband be dead, she is loosed from the law of her husband. So then if, while her husband liveth, she be married to another man, she shall be called an adulteress, but if her husband be dead, she is free from that law, so that she is no adulteress, though she be married to another man. 15. Isaiah 51 Thus saith the Lord, Where is the bill of your mother's divorcement, whom I have put away? Or which of my creditors, is it to whom I have sold you? Behold, for your iniquities have ye sold yourselves, and for your transgressions is your mother put away. 16. Leviticus 21:14 A widow, or a divorced woman, or profane, or an harlot, these shall he not take, but he shall take a virgin of his own people to wife. 1 John 2:3-4 And hereby we do know that we know him, if we keep his commandments. He that saith, I know him, and keepeth not his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in Jeremiah 3:8 And I saw, when for all the causes whereby backsliding Israel committed adultery I had put her away, and given her a bill of divorce, yet her treacherous sister Judah feared not, but went and played the harlot also. 17. Isaiah 54:6 For the Lord hath called thee as a woman forsaken and grieved in spirit, and a wife of youth, when thou wast refused, saith thy God. 18. Numbers 39. But every vow of a widow, and of her that is divorced, wherewith they have bound their souls, shall stand against her. 19. Matthew 19:7 They say unto him, Why did Moses then command to give a writing of divorcement, and to put her away? 20. Leviticus 22:13 But if the priest's daughter be a widow, or divorced, and have no child, and is returned unto her father's house, as in her youth, she shall eat of her father's meat, but there shall be no stranger eat thereof. 21, Mark 10:4 and they said, Moses suffered to write a bill of divorcement and to put her away. 22, 1 Corinthians 7:11-13, but and if she depart, let her remain unmarried or be reconciled to her husband. And let not the husband put away his wife. But to the rest speak I, not the Lord. If any brother hath a wife that believeth not, and she be pleased to dwell with him, let him not put her away. And the woman which hath an husband that believeth not, and if he be pleased to dwell with her, let her not leave him. 23. Hebrews 13:4 Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled, but whoremongers and adulterers God will judge. 24. Exodus 14:14 The Lord shall fight for you, and ye shall hold your peace. 25. 1 Corinthians 7:12 But to the rest speak I, not the Lord, if any brother hath a wife that believeth not, and she be pleased to dwell with him, let him not put her away. 26. 1 Corinthians 7:10 And unto the married I command, yet not I, but the Lord, let not the wife depart from her husband. 27. 1 Corinthians 7:13 And the woman which hath an husband that believeth not, and if he be pleased to dwell with her, let her not leave him. 28. Matthew 19:8-9 He saith unto them, Moses, because of the hardness of your hearts, suffered you to put away your wives, but from the beginning it was not so. And I say unto you, whosoever shall put away his wife, except it be for fornication, and shall marry another, committeth adultery, and whoso marrieth her which is put away doth commit adultery. 29. Romans 7:3 So then if, while her husband liveth, she be married to another man, she shall be called an adulteress, but if her husband be dead, she is free from that law, so that she is no adulteress, though she be married to another man. 30. Matthew 19:4-6 And he answered and said unto them, Have ye not read, that he which made them at the beginning, made them male and female, and said, For this cause shall a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain, shall be one flesh? Wherefore they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. 31. Mark 10:11-12 And he saith unto them, Whosoever shall put away his wife, and marry another, committeth adultery against her. And if a woman shall put away her husband, and be married to another, she committeth adultery. 32. Malachi 2:14-16 Yet ye say, Wherefore? Because the Lord hath been witness between thee and the wife of thy youth, against whom thou hast dealt treacherously. Yet is she thy companion, and the wife of thy covenant. And did not he make one? Yet had he the residue of the Spirit. And wherefore one? That he might seek a godly seed. Therefore take heed to your spirit, and let none deal treacherously against the wife of his youth. For the Lord, the God of Israel, saith that he hateth putting away, for one covereth violence with his garment, saith the Lord of hosts, therefore take heed to your spirit, that ye deal not treacherously. 33. Deuteronomy 24:1 When a man hath taken a wife, and married her, and it come to pass, that she find no favor in his eyes, because he hath found some uncleanness in her, then let him write her a bill of divorcement, and give it in her hand, and send her out of his house. 34. Genesis 2:18 And the Lord God said, It is not good, that the man should be alone. I will make him an help meet for him. 35. 1 Timothy 3:2 A bishop then must be blameless, the husband of one wife, vigilant, sober, of good behavior, given to hospitality, apt to teach. 36. Malachi 2:15 And did not he make one? Yet had he the residue of the Spirit. And wherefore one? That he might seek a godly seed. Therefore take heed to your spirit, and let none deal treacherously against the wife of his youth. 37. Jeremiah 29:11 For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace, and not of evil, to give you an expected end. 38. Exodus 20:14 Thou shalt not commit adultery. 39. Malachi 2:13-16 And this have ye done again, covering the altar of the Lord with tears, with weeping, and with crying out, insomuch that he regardeth not the offering any more, or receiveth it with goodwill at your hand. Yet ye say, Wherefore? Because the Lord hath been witness between thee, and the wife of thy youth, against whom thou hast dealt treacherously, yet is she thy companion, and the wife of thy covenant. And did not he make one? Yet had he the residue of the Spirit. And wherefore one? That he might seek a godly seed. Therefore take heed to your spirit, and let none deal treacherously against the wife of his youth. For the Lord, the God of Israel, saith that he hateth putting away, for one covereth violence with his garment, saith the Lord of hosts, therefore take heed to your spirit, that ye deal not treacherously. 40, Ezra 10 1-16 Now when Ezra had prayed, and when he had confessed, weeping and casting himself down before the house of God, there assembled unto him out of Israel a very great congregation of men and women and children, for the people wept very sore. And Shechaniah the son of Jehiel, one of the sons of Elam, answered and said unto Ezra, We have trespassed against our God, and have taken strange wives of the people of the land, yet now there is hope in Israel concerning this thing. Now therefore let us make a covenant with our God, to put away all the wives, and such as are born of them, according to the counsel of my Lord, and of those that tremble at the commandment of our God, and let it be done according to the law. Arise, for this matter belongeth unto thee, we also will be with thee, be of good. 41. Nehemiah 13:23-30 In those days also saw Jews that had married wives of Ashdod, of Ammon, and of Moab. And their children spake half in the speech of Ashdod, and could not speak in the Jews' language, but according to the language of each people. And I contended with them, and cursed them, and smote certain of them, and plucked off their hair, and made them swear by God, saying, Ye shall not give your daughters unto their sons, nor take their daughters unto your sons, or for yourselves. Did not Solomon king of Israel sin by these things? Yet among many nations was there no king like him, who was beloved of his God, and God made him king over all Israel, nevertheless even him did outlandish women cause to sin. 42. Proverbs 21:19 It is better to dwell in the wilderness than with a contentious and an angry woman. 43. Exodus 21:7-11 And if a man sell his daughter to be a maidservant, she shall not go out as the menservants do. If she please not her master, who hath betrothed her to himself, then shall he let her be redeemed. To sell her unto a strange nation he shall have no power, seeing he hath dealt deceitfully with her. And if he have betrothed her unto his son, he shall deal with her after the manner of daughters. If he take him another wife, her food, her raiment, and her duty of marriage, shall he not diminish. And if he do not these three unto her, then shall she go out free without money. 44. Proverbs 30:21-23 For three things the earth is disquieted, and for four which it cannot bear, for a servant when he reineth, and a fool when he is filled with meat, for an odious woman when she is married, and an handmaid that is heir to her mistress. 45. John 15:13 Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. 46. Isaiah 40:31 But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength, they shall mount up with wings as eagles, they shall run, and not be weary, and they shall walk, and not faint. 47. Matthew 5:27-28 Ye have heard that it was said by them of old time, Thou shalt not commit adultery, but I say unto you, that whosoever looketh on a woman to lust after her hath committed adultery with her already in his heart. 48. Leviticus 20:10 And the man that committeth adultery with another man's wife, even he that committeth adultery with his neighbor's wife, the adulterer and the adulteress shall surely be put to death. 49. Proverbs 20:25 It is a snare to the man who devoureth that which is holy, and after vows to make inquiry. 50. Titus 1:6 If any be blameless, the husband of one wife, having faithful children not accused of riot or unruly. 51. Matthew 19:5 And said, For this cause shall a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh? 52. Matthew 12:25 And Jesus knew their thoughts, and said unto them, Every kingdom divided against itself is brought to desolation, and every city or house divided against itself shall not stand. 53. 1 Peter 3:7 Likewise, ye husbands, dwell with them according to knowledge, giving honor unto the wife, as unto the weaker vessel, and as being heirs together of the grace of life, that your prayers be not hindered. 54. Proverbs 21:1 The king's heart is in the hand of the Lord, as the rivers of water, he turneth it whithersoever he will. 55. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. 56. 1 Peter 3:1. Wives, in the same way, submit yourselves to your own husbands so that, if any of them do not believe the word, they may be won over without words by the behavior of their wives. 57. Matthew 5:31-32. It has been said, anyone who divorces his wife must give her a certificate of divorce. But I tell you, that anyone who divorces his wife, except for sexual immorality, makes her the victim of adultery, and anyone who marries a divorced woman commits adultery. 58. Luke 16:18. Anyone who divorces his wife and marries another woman commits adultery, and the man who marries a divorced woman commits adultery. 59. 1 Corinthians 7:39. A woman is bound to her husband as long as he lives. But if her husband dies, she is free to marry anyone she wishes, but he must belong to the Lord. 60. Matthew 19 6-7. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore what God has joined together, let no one separate. Why then, they asked, did Moses command that a man give his wife a certificate of divorce and send her away? 61. Romans 7 2-3. For example, by law a married woman is bound to her husband as long as he is alive, but if her husband dies, she is released from the law that binds her to him. So then, if she has sexual relations with another man while her husband is still alive, she is called an adulteress. But if her husband dies, she is released from that law, and is not an adulteress, if she marries another man. 62. Deuteronomy 22:19. They shall fine him 100 shekels of silver and give them to the young woman's father, because this man has given an Israelite virgin a bad name. She shall continue to be his wife, he must not divorce her as long as he lives. 63. Jeremiah 3:1. If a man divorces his wife, and she leaves him, and marries another man, should he return to her again? Would not the land be completely defiled? But you have lived as a prostitute with many lovers, would you now return to me, declares the Lord. 64. Malachi 2:16. The man who hates and divorces his wife, says the Lord, the God of Israel, does violence to the one he should protect, says the Lord Almighty. So be on your guard, and do not be unfaithful. 65. Jeremiah 3:8. I gave faithless Israel her certificate of divorce and sent her away because of all her adulteries. Yet I saw that her unfaithful sister Judah had no fear, she also went out and committed adultery. 66. Deuteronomy 24 1-4. If a man marries a woman who becomes displeasing to him, because he finds something indecent about her, and he writes her a certificate of divorce, gives it to her, and sends her from his house, and if after she leaves his house she becomes the wife of another man, and her second husband dislikes her, and writes her a certificate of divorce, gives it to her, and sends her from his house, or if he dies, then her first husband, who divorced her, is not allowed to marry her again, after she has been defiled. That would be detestable in the eyes of the Lord. Do not bring sin upon the land the Lord your God is giving you as an inheritance. 67. Hebrews 13:4. Marriage should be honored by all, and the marriage bed kept pure, for God will judge the adulterer and all the sexually immoral. 68. Romans 7:3. So then, if she has sexual relations with another man, while her husband is still alive, she is called an adulteress. But if her husband dies, she is released from that law, and is not an adulteress, if she marries another man. We hope Bible verses helped bring peace to you today. My prayer for you this day is for healing for your marriage as you seek the will of God for your life. So if you like to hear and watch video Bible online, and you are passionate about the Bible, you are in the right place. It's best to subscribe with the notification bell, so you don't miss out on new videos. Stay blessed.